live from the Dunkin' Latte Lounge.
Welcome to the Dunkin' Latte Lounge. My name is Gareth from Elvis Duran and the Z100 Morning Show. Coming poolside, well, the pool is covered, as you can see. We welcome in John Kay. What's up, man?
Garrett, what's up, bro?
It's so cool, and we can get caught up on the last handful of years of what you've been up to, but I want to say, how have you been able to celebrate such a huge milestone with going platinum? I would have jumped in the pool, but it looks like your pool is covered.
You know, sadly, it got covered yesterday.
Oh, yesterday. Okay.
But so I did have an opportunity after it happened. I did. I jumped off the diving board and got it's incredible, man. I think it's a testament to not giving up. It's a testament to being vulnerable, doing things that you believe in, and in that particular song, If We Never Met, I was just trying to tell my story the best that I could. And there was something special in that moment. And I was able to connect with myself and with the song. And I think that that is why people have gravitated towards that song.
Yeah,
that's
no,
the only
it sticks.
Reason
yeah.
I can think of. And it's a total blessing. And I'm honored to call it a platinum record.
And yeah, we'll hear about it and talk about it a little bit more.
A cake. I don't know if you can see that. If We Never Met platinum cake.
All right, so we'll talk about that in just a second. So you said you're in the New York area right now for a little bit longer before heading back home.
Yeah, man. I've been quarantining out with my wife's family on Long Island for the last 2 months, just to switch it up, I think.
Right.
And I've been doing a lot of Zoom sessions here, and so the grind has still been the same. But you know, the Long Island summers. Gorgeous.
Oh, it's so beautiful. You can't compete with anything else, except like Hawaii, but that's a whole nother story.
Yeah, that's a little far.
So talk about as a writer, a musician, getting used to Zoom sessions. I mean, we're pretty much immune to it by now of sitting down and chatting via boxes, but as a songwriter, it's all about that connection. So how do you establish that connection with someone you're trying to accomplish something amazing with over the internet and make it sound like you're face to face in real life?
Yeah. I think it's just like anything else.
Was it weird at first and now you're used to it?
Yeah, it was at first. It was a lot of songwriters, myself included, were a little bit reluctant to jump in, but we made a commitment to not knowing how long this was going to be. So we jumped in early and started just kind of awkwardly trying to figure out the Zoom thing. I'm back in late March and April, and I'm happy that we did that because now it is something that almost feels normal, you know,
right.
And it allows me to stay home if I want to stay home, you know, like
There is no excuse. There is no excuse.
And there's no excuse. Yeah. You can't get away from it.
So it's like when you're working with someone, they're like, I can't make it to the studio. All right, let's hop on Zoom. It's sure.
Exactly.
No problem. All right. Just because it's my job and curious minds want to know, I saw you before we started sipping on some coffee, right? What do you got there?
I got it may look like a normal cup of coffee. But it's the Dunkin' Latte.
The Dunkin' Latte. Yep, there we go. People back in corporate are going to love that. And if you don't get at least a year supply of K-Cups after that, I don't know what happens. But let's talk Dunkin' real quick for a second. Like, being a songwriter and something you love, do you start writing music and be like, hey, why can't this be like in a Dunkin' commercial, or why can't this be in a movie? Like, do you start writing music that you could hear in film and in movies and on commercials?
Every single day. It's we're going for that Dunkin' plug every day. I think you can't chase it.
Right.
I think you have to write the best chance for me as an artist is to write music that's the most authentic to me, and then watch it hopefully connect and cross over. And have that ability to be in the movie. But yeah, we talk about that all the time. I think the main word we like to throw around is timeless, and a song that's going to stick around for a while.
I mean, you need not just in a movie, but that it could stand by itself. I think if I understand correctly, that doesn't necessarily in the movie, but it can play, you know, when the movie's totally forgotten about in 10, 20, 30 years. Yeah. All right. So reading up to, you've been talking about team, how your team challenges you to become a better writer, a better person. Like, what specifically, like, have you submitted a song and they're like, I think you could do better? Or is it just like challenging you in everyday life?
I mean, that's pretty much every single day. I mean, we write a lot of music. And
when you say a lot, how much is a lot?
I mean, just right now, it's 4 to 5, sometimes 6 Zoom sessions a week.
Wow.
And that's standard. You know, that gives us the ability to kind of load up on ideas and fight through the mediocre into the great, you know, and continue to raise the bar. And we have to spread out and write to hone in on what the sound feels like it is. If we're not touching on everything, and if I'm not exploring the full extent of my creativity, then I'll never be able to like lock in on, okay, what's something that feels like unique and authentic and genuine, and what feels like this. So I think at the end of the day, we're not afraid to call each other out.
Right.
And I'll run it through, you know, 4 or 5 different sets of ears, and they know the project as good, if not better, than I do. And it's a group effort of all of us honing our skills and offering up opinions in a safe place where we're not offended. We're just kind of like, okay, I think you're right. That pre could be better. Like, that doesn't hit me right, or gives you that perspective that you didn't have. So that's the value in the team.
Now, over, like you were saying about, you know, 4 to 6 Zoom sessions a week of just writing, like, how do you find inspiration when a lot of people are just stuck inside the four walls of their apartment or house and try to come up with new and different ways of telling a story?
Yeah, sometimes it's inspired and sometimes it's forced. You know,
right.
I'm not going to sit here and say I go in with this well thought out concept. Sometimes I roll in and I don't really have much, but then you get to get in front of somebody else who has a totally different well of creativity that you start throwing things back and forth. And before you know it, a melody turns into, oh, that feels like you're saying this, or it sounded like you said that. And then the concept is born and we're just kind of running, you know, and it's really fun. I think I really enjoy, other than performing, that initial spark when you grab onto something and you get what eventually feels like the concept of a song. Like, that moment is such a cool thing in a session.
Well, let's break down before you get into if we never met. Like, what about that? Like, can you take us to day one of that creating if we never met? Like, what was, do you remember it? Like, sitting down, like what the concept was and versus what it is today?
That song was supposed to be written. And I say that because Steph Jones and I, she's an amazing writer in LA. We got in the studio and I was actually going to sing a song that she had sent to my A&R, and we were only together in that room to cut a different song. And if I hadn't kind of opened up and said, do you think we could maybe write together instead of doing this? Like, I like this song, but can we write something instead? If she wasn't open to that, then we never would have sat down and started talking. And then we just honestly started talking about the project and how I met everybody. And Steph out of nowhere goes, so like, if you never met all these people, and
did the room freeze and was like, hold on.
It was just her and I. Dante was in the background.
But did everything stop? Like, almost like
everything
in the
movie. Stopped. I was like, I love that. And then we started throwing out all these hypotheticals. Like, if we never met, like, I wouldn't know. And then it was just open. Like, that was the anchor. And we had, if we never met, as the anchor first, and we were able to totally build the story around that. And that was 2 hours later, the song was done.
And let's get into it. So you're going to do a stripped down version for us, John Kay. This is If We Never Met.
Now, this song was when Dante and I, after the Duncan Lounge in 17, we started to go to LA and do all these writing trips, and we were there for 2 to 3 weeks at a time. And the song wasn't supposed to be written the day it was written. And we got in a studio, Dante played this little loop, and the song was written in a couple hours. And it's the most vulnerable I ever was in a room, and I think that that really shows in the record, and it's about the most special person in my whole life and the person I love the most on this earth, and it's called If We Never Met. Yeah. If we never met, I'd be drunk waking up in someone else's bed. I'd be lost in a crowded room of fake friends. I wouldn't even know what love is if we never met. Yeah. What if I never started singing? What if you never told your family you were leaving when you felt the pressure? There's a million different reasons we shouldn't be together. But when I put it all together, it all comes back to you. You, I love it when the only light is me, you, and the moon. Mm-hmm. And baby, when I close my eyes, I'm thinking about if we never met. Yeah, yeah. I'd be drunk waking up in someone else's bed. Yeah. I'd be lost in a crowded room of fake friends. I wouldn't even know what love is. Yeah. What if I never left Nashville? What if you never called me back when I asked you something to do about the weather? It all happened for a reason, yeah. Girl, you put me back together. And when I put it all together, ooh, it all comes back to you. I love it when the only light is me, you, and the moon. Baby, when I close my eyes, I'm thinking about if we never met. Yeah, yeah. I'd be drunk waking up in someone else's bed. Yeah. I'd be lost in a crowded room of fake friends. I wouldn't even know what love is if we never met. Oh.
All right, welcome back to the Dunkin' Latte Lounge, hanging out poolside with John Kay. And, you know, there's something different, and I don't know how you feel as an artist, too. The strip it all down to the bare essentials song versus a produced, you know, in the studio song, it's like night and day almost. Like, and you find a way to do it and make it seem different, but it's not. You know what I mean?
That's what I love to do the most.
Well, it must be a cool feeling knowing, like, I could take this song that I put so much effort and produced and make it sound the sonic sound to it, where I can literally just bare essentials and make it sound amazing.
Yeah, I think that's the true test of a great song is when we do go in and get a fully produced record, you kind of have to run it through the test of, well, does it also feel as good just piano vocal or guitar vocal,
right?
And that's when we know we have a really good song, when the concept, the lyrics, and the melody just are leading and feel good over very minimal instrumentation. You know, I don't think a song in this project will ever lie on the production to sell it, if that makes sense.
You know what I love too? We're talking, you know, as you're outside, I'm sitting in my kitchen too. You could hear the crickets in the backyard.
Yeah.
So, working via computer over the last couple of months too, like, have you had those like weird run-ins of, like, you know, you were saying you're right next door to a fire department where you're in the middle of work and then all of a sudden just chaos breaks loose for a couple of minutes?
Yeah, I'm waiting for it to happen any second, honestly.
Happens to me all the time. I have a 2-year-old and a 5-year-old, and on the radio, you got "Dad, I can't find my pants," or "The dog just ate my pancakes." You know, weird.
You gotta, you gotta sample that stuff and like use it and bring it back into the show. Like,
well,
Dad,
we're live.
I can't buy my pants.
Yeah, we're live. We're live. So it's like that's the thing about doing a radio show. You know, unlike a Zoom, you're just in, you know, talking to maybe 10 people, but you're on the radio. You don't know how many people are listening. You're talking to the people in the studio, and all of a sudden, a 2-year-old's complaining that her brother just like bit her. You know what I mean? So
yeah,
that's what I'm dealing with.
The main thing is I'll be recording vocals and Lily will be barking at something. And it's, I mean, luckily we're not live on air. We just kind of have to trash that take and do it over again. But there's been many just mid-cut barks. I think that's kind of the main thing.
It's one of those things, like when any type of normalcy gets back to 100%, we'll be like, remember when we were recording and Lily was like barking in the middle of the song? Like, you'll start to miss it, even though it's kind of annoying right now.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Let's.
I mean, that's the beautiful thing. Go ahead.
Let's talk about 6 months. You know, I got to see the video. Explain a little bit behind that. Explain the song too, because, you know, why not come straight to the source as opposed to me just kind of guessing about the song?
No, tell me. You tell me what it's about. How does it make you feel?
see, that's the open of interpretation. When I first started, I was like, 6 months, okay. And I was like, well, we've been in a pandemic for 6 months too. So I already start thinking pandemic. I already start thinking I've been trapped inside my house for 6 months, and then it just goes down a rabbit hole from there. Unlike you, where you have to, you have to make it more positive than my thoughts about it. So tell us about 6 months and the process of creating it.
It definitely hits different now. We actually released it in February, kind of before, you know.
On the cusp, like no one knew what was going on. No one could tell what the future looked like, so.
Right. Apparently, you know, we just had a very clear vision for what was going to happen. that was amidst a lot of trips to LA and a lot of time away from the girls that we loved. And we were kind of in the middle of, and when I say we, Dante and I were on a 3-week trip. It was right in the middle of the trip. And Dante just played this, that chord structure and had like, feels like it's been 6 months. And we, in that right, we started with that first line and just built the story straight out, which is kind of rare. Usually you start with a chorus and then build around that. But we were able to just kind of follow the feeling and follow the storyline right into what ended up being just a really cool, flowy kind of hug of a song, you know, really sweet. And
so when you guys said you were on a trip, were you traveling, performing, writing? What were you doing over there?
A 3-week writing trip in L.A. We were in sessions every single day.
Are you in studios? Like when you're writing, do you go straight to studios? Do you go to the Joshua Tree? I don't know. I'm not a writer, so that's why
it's a mixed bag. I mean, I would say 70% of them are at producers' houses or friends' houses. But we'll also sometimes jump in studios for sessions and wherever is the most comfortable for everybody.
All right, well, let's get to it right now, a stripped down version of 6 months with John Kay in the Dunkin' Latte Lounge.
Yeah. Feels like it's been 6 months and 7 days when I'm without you. There ain't no way I don't think about you, yeah. All I do is think about you, yeah. I love when you get so shy that your cheeks turn red. How am I the only guy inside your head? I'm thinking out loud, yeah. Girl, I'm just thinking out loud, baby, yeah. Cause baby, when we fall asleep, you know that you're safe with me. And baby, this is all we need, yeah. We're right where we belong. Wish I didn't have to go. It's hard to leave you all alone. Cause even when we're far from home, yeah, we're right where we belong. All the space between us, yeah, it starts to hurt. I'm getting jealous of my own t-shirt, the way it holds you, yeah. You know I wish that I could hold you, yeah, yeah. Haven't slept in 3 nights. Yeah, you're on my mind. Flipping through photographs to pass the time. I'm thinking about you. Yeah. Girl, I'm always thinking about you. Baby, when we fall asleep, you know that you're safe with me. And baby, this is all we need, yeah. 'Cause we're right where we belong. I wish I didn't have to go. It's hard to leave you all alone, even when we're far from home. Yeah, we're right where we belong. Ah, yeah. Ah, you know I'll always love you.
Welcome back to the Dunkin' Latte Lounge, still hanging out with John Kay. I mean, just thinking about your career, you know, it feels, no pun intended, you just sang 6 months, but, and though right now those 6 months feel like 6 years for us in general, looking back in the last few years, is it still like, do you get those goosebumps? Do you still pinch yourself in the sense of like, this is happening? Like, I can't, believe it, but I still can't believe it.
Yeah, I mean, we were supposed to be on the road, man. We were supposed to be touring, playing. We had so many shows lined up. So my heart breaks from that standpoint of being able to really connect with people. But I also know that there's a lot of songs that we're going to find very, very soon from a lot of different artists that I believe that there's going to be a lot of music created that never could have existed without this. So that's if you true. Look at it from more of a half full perspective of, it gave me more time to focus on my relationships with people around me, to hold the things that I love closely, and to really look at this music with a different lens and go into detail on a greater level, rather than kind of fly around and just do a bunch of things. It was like, gave me time to hone in more on the artistry, and that I will always kind of cherish that, this different time, as tough as it's been. It's also been really, really rewarding to almost just sit back and realize you have no control and kind of absorb the creativity in that.
Just roll with it. Yeah. Well, now, so John, let's clear the pathway for the future. Arenas could, you know, people can go back into arenas and venues, and you're about to go on stage for the first time in, you know, a very long time, just like many of artists. What's that first song you're just jonesing to get up on stage right now to perform?
It's a song that's going to be released in like a month or so. I have the show opening song will be also be the first song off of the next batch of music that we release.
That's a great tune, by the way.
It's the truth. It's just like the perfect song for the adrenaline of getting back on stage. Like, I can hear the drummer just like kicking it off. And I always start off stage, and the drummer goes, the band starts jamming, and then I just run on stage and then we just go to work.
Do you call your drummer and go, hey, I think I got a song. I got the song. And
Danny, you're going to love this, bro. You're going to love this.
Trust me, you're going to love it.
Yeah.
All right. So before I let you go, we're going to get into happiness in a second, but let's cover all socials, how people can connect, stay in touch, keep updated if they're not already.
John K Music. Hit me up. Instagram. Twitter is John K, but mostly, yeah, I think at John K Music on Instagram. We're about to roll out a good amount of music, and I don't know if it would happen without quarantine the way it's been, but I think the world needs music, and I'm going to give it to them. So hit me up at John K Music. We got some more for you.
And of course, you can go back and watch this over and over again, DunkinLatteLounge.com, hashtag DunkinLatteLounge, all on social media. But John, before we get into it, tell us a little bit about Happiness.
Happiness was a song that didn't quit, and it didn't give up on itself. It was a song that we worked a million different ways for a very, very long time. And I don't know if it was ever going to come out until it made a lot of sense with everything that everybody's going through right now to put out a song that is personifying happiness as an old friend you haven't seen in a while. And
no, go ahead.
We just heard it and it was like, okay, we have to stop overthinking the song. We have to stop trying to change production and we just need to release it. Because I think it can help a lot of people as it helped us kind of cope with 2020.
Now, as an artist, before we get into it, is it tough at times to step away from a project and go, I think we're overthinking this, like you just said?
And I think that's the hardest thing about it.
Right.
And the best feeling in the world is when it's released and you can no longer tweak it. But when I tell you that there is more than a dozen versions of Happiness, I might be undercutting it. Like it was to the point where I didn't even know what the record was supposed to sound like anymore because we tried so many different
things. It wasn't
making
you happy.
It wasn't making me happy. Far from it. But I'm happy that it's out.
All right. So let's get into it right now. John Cade, thank you very much. Good luck getting back home. And we appreciate you hanging in the Dunkin' Latte Lounge. And we leave you now with John Cade and Happiness.
Pleasure to be here. Thank you, guys.
Wasted away on the sofa and so far I can't see the end. Nah. Wake me when all this is over, the water is over my head. I feel like my daydreams are nightmares. I feel like a prisoner in my bed. Yeah, now it's hard to remember what it's like to feel better. I wonder if I'll feel it again. Happiness, where you been, where you gone, are you coming back? It's been so long since I looked in the mirror and saw someone who reminds me of when I do. Lately I'm so far from sober that nothing will take off the edge. Hey yeah, waiting for something to save me, cause I don't know where to begin. I feel like my daydreams are nightmares, and I feel like a prisoner in my head. Yeah, now it's hard to remember what it's like to feel better. I wonder if I feel it again. Happiness, where you been, where you gone, are you coming back? It's been so long since I looked in the mirror, saw someone who reminds me of when I knew you. Oh, happiness, if you're real, prove me wrong, cause I'm losing faith. It's been so long since I looked in the mirror and saw someone who reminds me of when I knew you. I feel like my daydreams are nightmares. I feel like a prisoner in my head. Now it's hard to remember. It's like to feel better. Wonder if I'll feel it again. Happiness, where you been, where you gone, are you coming back? It's been so long since I looked in the mirror, saw someone who reminds me of when I knew you. Oh, happiness, if you're real, prove me wrong, cause I'm losing faith. It's been so long since I looked in the mirror, saw someone who reminds me of when I knew you.
Thank you guys, much love.
Live from the Dunkin' Latte Lounge,